You just started your career as a software engineer. You've been finishing all the tasks assigned to you with good quality. But what's next? What does it take for you to get promoted? Understanding what the path looks like and putting your energy onto the right things can help you grow towards the next level in no time. Before you work on your promotion, please make sure you've watched my last video, which talked about the first couple of steps you have to take to establish a good foundation for your growth. Otherwise, pushing for promotion too soon can be seen as premature. I've left the link in the description below. The rest of this video assumes that you have already done those steps and reached consistent productivity. To get ready for your promotion, first, you need to understand what the key difference is between L4 and L3. We covered this in a previous video, which also has a link in the description. Long story short, L3s primarily focus on executing small tasks, while L4s need to start owning features. Features are slightly more complex, and each of them can take several weeks to complete. L4s are expected to have enough self-direction to deal with that complexity and can break features down into small, actionable tasks that they can then either execute by themselves or delegate to L3s. Now that you understand the key difference, getting promoted to L4 is all about demonstrating your readiness to take on that complexity. I will share 4 tips that I've seen proven over and over again to be extremely effective at helping L3 engineers grow towards the next level. Tip number 1, become proactive. When you are an L3, typically someone else more senior is assigning you tasks, which implies that by default, you are working passively, mostly reacting to those assignments. So the first transformation you should focus on is to go from passive to proactive. After you are getting close to finishing the tasks assigned to you, ask yourself, what are the next set of things that would be valuable to the project or to the team? Maybe the team has a central backlog of other tasks that you can pick from. Maybe there are previously identified bugs or feature requests that are well-defined and ready for execution. Or maybe the next step is not entirely clear and the team should get together and brainstorm. Whatever that is, you can try to be the one that proposes what you or the team should do next. Once you have some candidate ideas, you can bring this to your tech lead, PM, or your manager to see if your proposal makes sense. Usually, they will appreciate your proactiveness and either tell you to go for it or give you some feedback that may refine the proposal. Whichever case that is, you are establishing to them that you are self-directing, which sets the foundation for their confidence in your readiness for promotion. Besides proposing next steps for yourself, you can also proactively identify opportunities to improve the team's code quality, tools, or processes. As you work on your own tasks, try to keep an eye on things that are slowing you down, whether it's a lack of documentation, poorly structured code, or insufficient test coverage. They are all great opportunities for you to add value. Once you have a good list of opportunities identified, you can start to carve out a small portion of your time to get them improved. Prioritize the things that are causing the most pain, and share with your team once they're done so others can benefit from your work as well. Pretty soon, your proactive contribution here will get noticed and appreciated. Now, tip number 2, start managing your manager. Wait, what? Yes, you heard it right. A big part of your manager's job is to help you succeed and grow, and you can manage them to do that job well. I will have a future video that specifically talks about managing up, so please remember to subscribe if you don't want to miss it. The way to put your manager to work on your promotion is by having a career discussion in one of your one-on-one meetings. Don't be afraid or worried about being the one that initiates this. It's literally your manager's job to help you with it. Worst case scenario, your manager will point out that there are still some gaps you need to close before you are ready for promotion. which is actually going to be very helpful for you to know about, because otherwise those gaps will remain open and will block your promotion without your knowledge. Here's an example of how you can approach this conversation. Hey manager, I have been working on this project for a couple of weeks and I was able to make consistent progress. I would love to hear your feedback on whether I was meeting expectations. Oh hey Kun, you have been doing great here. Your productivity has been consistent and the quality of your work has been pretty solid. I really appreciate having you on the team. Thanks a lot, that's great to hear. I've been thinking that maybe I should push myself out of the comfort zone and start growing towards the next level. Can you maybe share your advice on how I should approach that? I'm really glad that you'd like to push yourself. How about let me write down a growth plan for us to discuss in our next one-on-one? There, that's how you get your manager to work for you. And everyone wants their plan to succeed. And so you know that your manager is now very aware and motivated to help you get there. Tip number 3, plan your work upfront. A likely outcome of the growth plan your manager puts together is that you will start to take on some independent features. And when that happens, you need to explicitly shift the way you operate from executing tasks one at a time into a habit of planning ahead. For example, when you take on a feature, instead of jumping straight into coding, first spend some time to break it down into individual tasks and create a timeline for exactly what you would be working on for at least the next 2 weeks. Gantt charts is a useful tool to help you with that. And here's a simple example of what it looks like. Very often though, you will realize some of the tasks are something you have never done before. In such cases, it's very important for you to explicitly plan some buffer time to account for the learning curve and the unknowns. As a general rule of thumb, for something that's completely new to you, estimate twice as much time as what you think it will take to allow yourself to have the buffer you need. Or you could consult with more experienced people and get their inputs on how much time it will take for you to learn. Once you have your timeline laid out, share it with your tech lead or other more senior people on the team for feedback. And they may give you some suggestions that can refine your proposal and allow you to have a higher chance of success. My last tip today is to be aware and manage your dependencies. Many projects fail to deliver on time, not because of the team not working hard enough, but because of the owner not paying enough attention to dependencies. In order for you to land your feature, you might need to depend on some other people's work. It could be a product design spec that's not quite ready yet. It could be a shared component that's still in development by another team. Or it could require someone's approval and that person is going on a long vacation. The first thing you should do in order to manage your dependencies is to identify what they are. Once you've broken down your feature into a list of tasks, examine each task closely and ask yourself, do I have everything I need to complete this task? Through this exercise, you may realize that there are a few things that are outside of your direct control. These are your dependencies. You should then figure out who controls those dependencies and just talk to them. The important thing here is to not make assumptions that these dependencies will pan out by themselves, because most of the time they don't, unless someone pushes them forward. When you talk to people who control those dependencies, make sure you explicitly ask for their estimate for when the dependencies will get resolved. If you don't get clear answers, that's a red flag that this particular dependency might be at risk. For the ones that are risky, you have a few options. 1. Replace them with something else that's less risky. This is often the best choice, even when the alternative is to use an old system that doesn't look so shiny. 2. Escalate the risk to your tech lead or manager to see if there are things they can do to help. Maybe they know a better solution, or maybe they can pull some strings to accelerate the resolution of those dependencies. Either way, this gives you a chance at mitigating the risk. The last option is to acknowledge the risk and communicate it out to all the stakeholders that your project is at risk as well. This gives stakeholders an opportunity to react accordingly, because they could have their own plans that depend on your project. Using these four tips effectively should give you a significant advantage at getting your first promotion. If you have any questions, please comment below and I will share my answers. See you next time.